watching him make his way to the ring. And I'm thinking with many wrestlers, they would have quickly run to James J. Dillon complaining about another obstacle put ahead of him. But we heard nothing from Goldberg. We heard nothing. We just saw many glimpses of the man in his own locker room, bashing his head into a locker, getting prepared for another battle. It makes no difference to Goldberg. And that's what I think is one of the reasons he is such a phenomenon. And that is, it seems to me, that it matters not who he gets in the ring against. It's all the same to Goldberg.
You really have to wonder if he prepares a specific strategy for his opponents. From what we've seen from Goldberg in the course of those 106 victories, it's just been full speed ahead.
Now you notice the referee.
Don't get his attention, Hall.
The referee put the U.S. title belt up high, so I'm assuming that means that Scott Hall wins. Yes, he'll be the U.S. champ. This is a U.S. title bout, and it's also a step towards Goldberg getting the shot against Hogan later tonight if he can win. And there is obvious the power differential there.
I think the last thing Goldberg needed was a wake-up call from Scott Hall.
He's awake. Look at him. He's awake.
And focused. You can see it in his eyes.
Scott Hall with his trademark shoulder thrust.
You know, he's a pro, this Hall. He can make you make a mistake. He's beaten some of the biggest names in this sport. He's probably one of the top 10 wrestlers in this sport today.
But look at the takedown by Goldberg.
He's ready. Tonight's his night. He feels it. He's got the momentum. Once in a lifetime opportunity for him, maybe.
I look at this and I look at the scenario and I can only wonder that obviously putting Scott Hall in here to face Goldberg was a plan of NWO Hollywood. But what's the backup plan? What's the second protocol?
Whoa!
And those are heavy, heavy hits. You can see him and feel it.
Oh!
Scott Hall went down hard. Hall hit the ropes and Goldberg.
Goldberg just bowled him into the ropes.
There goes two teeth.
Scott Hall just taunting the man now.
Mind games on the part of Scott Hall.
Trying to slam the man.
He blocks it, though.
Oh, look.
If he's got any, his danger's up right now.
It looks so easy.
It's not.
No, it's not, but he is so strong. He is so focused.
Look at those eyes.
Every move with such ease.
He's a hunter.
That's exactly what he is, Bray. And Hall is trying, oh! He's trying everything to get him to come unglued. Nothing's working.
Every move with ease, but every move with incredible physical impact, and Scott Hall again stops him with a boot to the midsection.
And I see frustration out of Scott Hall. I don't think he really knows what to do with this man.
Into the corner. No, sir. He sidestepped him is what he did. And he got him in the back of the head. Sometimes your best offense is a good defense.
Whoa.
And we're seeing that from Scott Hall. He put him down.
This could be it.
Backdrop suplexed him. He's got the cover.
They had the cover for only a fleeting one count. But that was as close as anyone's gotten to Goldberg right there. Now the chant starts.
Listen to it.
Trying to shake it off. And I tell you, you can see it rocks his head back. Those are hard, heavy hits from Scott Hall.
But he's made it to his feet.
That was a right cross. He's standing, he's alive. Daring Hall to hit him, which he did.
Oh, man, what a match.
Too much power.
The crowd erupts 40,000 strong with the armbar takeover and the deep arm drag to follow.
Showing us a little new twist to his repertoire.
And don't think for a second Hogan's eyes aren't peeled on that TV. He's going to be about an inch from that set watching everything because he knows Goldberg gets by that man. You're next.
All right, I talked about second protocol. I talked about ultimate plan. Scott Hall is waving someone down.
He's calling for the troops. That's what he's doing.
The Disciple. Vincent. Hold on. Hold on. It's, oh. It's DDP. And Karl Malone wielding chairs.
Picking him off one by one.
Standing up for Goldberg.
And Goldberg's in control.
Oh, he was.
Nah, he still is.
Scott Hall with a great move. And he goes down.
This could be the turning point right here. He hasn't gone this long yet, has he?
No, and that clothesline rocked him.
It really did. It really did. They start to can again. Scott Hall says it's over.
Goldberg trying to shake off the after effects of that vicious lariat from Scott Hall.
He's going for his outsider edge.
This man has held tag team champions everything.
Oh!
Didn't even use his hands. Just with his neck. He threw him halfway across that ring.
Scott Hall hurt his knee as he tries to get to his feet. Watch out for mine!
I smell 107, gentlemen.
I smell Jackhammer.
Yeah, and I think we all smell Hollywood Hogan.
If you're close to him, you do.
Up! And down!
Who's next?
Later on in this program, the man undaunted at 107-0. Fans standing and screaming. Later on, Goldberg will face tonight live Hollywood Hogan for the World Heavyweight Championship. And they're chanting his name still. Goldberg, as focused as ever, stalks away from the ring only to realize in a few moments he'll come back in, Bobby the Brain.
Get a shot of this. Scott Hall's got him ready. Didn't even use his hands. Just threw that big 280-pound man across the ring with his neck. Takes him out right here. I can feel it now. I know he's going to win this match. Hall's not getting up. Picks him up on that jackhammer. 40,000 in attendance. Millions at home watching as this man, Goldberg, gets the 1-2-3 on one of the top athletes in this sport. And they say, who's next? It's spelled H-O-L-L-Y, W-O-O-D, Hollywood. Bring him on.
Tonight, it will happen. Goldberg will go into the ring later on live in this program for the World Heavyweight title against Hollywood Hogan. Stay right where you are.